Let's start question 3, exercise 3.1. Here, question is, what is the sum of measures of the angles of a convex quadrilateral? Will this property hold if the quadrilateral is not convex? Here, you have to find out the sum of angles of convex quadrilateral. So firstly, let's take a convex quadrilateral. This is an example of convex quadrilateral. And we did this property, sum of angles. In the previous class, we did sum of angles of quadrilateral. It's 360 degree. As we did, we just take a line here and we'll form it in two triangles. As we know that sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So if we will add these all angles, as there are two triangles, as we will add these four angles, we'll get 180 plus 180 is equal to 360 degree. So what is our answer here? That the sum of angles of a convex quadrilateral is 360 degree. Now they are asking whether this property hold for concave also or not. Not convex. Not convex matlab concave. Let's take a concave polygon now with the four sides. It can be like this. Here we have four sides. Right? So here also four angles are here. So will this property hold for this concave quadrilateral also? So our answer will be yes. Because here also we can form two triangles, and as we know that sum of angles is equal to 180 degree. So here also sum of angles of this quadrilateral also will also be 360 degree. So yes, this property holds for concave also, because we can form here also two triangles, right? Question number 4, examine the table. Each figure is divided into four triangles and sum of angles deduced from that. So here we found a formula. From here, we can found formula. Let's see how. See, if we have three sides, we know that sum of angle is equal to 180 degree. If we have four sides, then we can just form here two triangles, right? We can convert into two triangles, and as sum of angles is equal to 180, so here we have two triangles and sum of angle will be 2 into 180 degree. Similarly, in pentagon, we can make here three triangles. Then sum of angle will be 3 into 180 degree, right? And if we take six sides like hexagon, then we can form here four triangles. So sum of angle will be 4 into 180 degree. So now here we can make the formula. If we observe it, then we can see if the sides are three. If the sides are three, so we can say 3 minus 2 into 180. That is 1 into 180, right? 1 into 180. कि अगर हम number of sides में से 2 minus कर दे और 180 multiply करें, then we'll get the sum of angles here. 4 sides, 4 minus 2, 2 into 180. 360 degree, right? 5 sides, we can say here 5 sides hai to 5 mein se 2 minus kar do, 3, 3 multiply 180 degree, right? And it will be 540 degree. So similarly here 6 sides hai, 6 mein se 2 minus kar do, 4 into 180 degree, that is 720 degree. Right? So here, like this way, we can find out sum of angles by using this formula, n minus 2 multiply 180 degree. Right? This is the rule now. How we can do it? See, in the question now, what you have to tell here? What can you say about when the sum number of side is equal to 7? What can you say about the angle sum of a convex polygon? When the number of side is 7, so kya karenge using the formula? 7 mein se 2 minus kar denge, multiply kar denge 180 degree, it will be 5 into 180 degree is equal to 900 degree. Right? Similarly, when the sides are 8, when the number of sides are 8, so what will be the sum of angles here? 8 minus 2, if there is a polygon whose sides are 8, then sum of angles will be 8 minus 2 into 180 degree. That is 5 into 180 degree. Sorry, 6 is equal to 1080 degree. Right? Similarly, 10. 10 minus 2 into 180 degree. And how to find out n here? It will be n minus 2 multiply 180 degree. Right? It will be n minus 2 into 180 degree. So here we get the formula. If we subtract 2 from number of sides and then multiply by 180 degree, then we'll get sum of angles of the given convex polygon. Right? Next question is, what can you say about what is the regular polygon? What is the regular polygon here? The polygon whose all sides and angles are equal, that is called regular polygon. Polygon whose all angles and sides are equal, that is called regular polygon. Right? So here they are asking, state the name of a regular polygon of 3 sides. If there are 3 sides, so what will be the name of the regular polygon? If there are 3 sides, what it will be? Equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle has, what is equilateral triangle here? Whose all sides and angles are equal and has 3 sides. Okay, so that is a regular polygon of 3 sides. That is called equilateral triangle. 4 sides, if in a polygon 4 sides are equal and angles are also equal, then it will be a square. It will be a square. And 6 sides. What about 6 sides? If there are 6 sides, so obviously it's a hexagon. It's a hexagon. But we'll mention here regular hexagon. Because 3 sides, if they are equal, then we'll say that equilateral triangle. If there are 4 sides, we'll say square. Phir jaise hum pentagon ya hexagon septagon pe jaate hain, if their all sides and angles are equal, then we'll mention as regular pentagon, regular hexagon, regular septagon, like this, right? So it will be regular hexagon. Next, question number 6. Find the measure x in the following figures. Here you have to find out measure of angle x in this given figure. How to find it out? So you can see here angles are given. So definitely you will use angle sum property here of a quadrilateral. Now it's a quadrilateral. Here we have 4 sides. 4 sides are here. So what is angle sum property of a quadrilateral? That sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. So let's apply that property. One of the angle is x. Other angle is 50 degree. 130 degree. 120 degree is equal to 360 degree. Right? Then x plus add these 300 degree is equal to 360 degree. Subtract this here. X is equal to 360 degree minus 300 degree is equal to 60 degree. So here the value of X is 60 degree because sum of angle is 360. So here we can find out the unknown angle, that is X, by using angle sum property. The next part is part B is, here again you have to find out the value of x. So here we are, talking about angle sum property of quadrilateral, so, and all other polygons, we are talking about here interior angles. here we are not talking about interior angles. So here, as we have given exterior angle, so we'll find out interior angle here. What will be the interior angle here? First of all, we will mention this. This is angle 1. And this one will also be 90 degree. As this line is straight, outside angle is 90. This is the sine of 90 degree. So inside this angle will also be 90, as this is a straight line. So now again, it's a quadrilateral. These angles, we have given 3 angles. We have to find out this x. How to find it out now? See, angle 1 is equal to 90 degree first of all, because what we have given here, straight line, right? Here we have given the line straight. You can mention in the bracket angles on straight line. So angle 1 will be equal to 90 degree. Then, when 1 is 90, so here we can use now angle sum property as x plus 90 plus 70 plus 60 is equal to 360 degree. Then, x plus, add all this, 260 degree. Sorry, 60. 90 plus 70, 160, 160 plus 60, 220 degree is equal to 360 degree. Then x is equal to 360 degree minus 220 degree is equal to how much it will be? 140 degree, right? It will be 140 degree. Next is C part. Here also you have to find out x, and here we have given pentagon. Here we have 5 sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this 5 side. So here we'll use angle sum property of pentagon, not quadrilateral. So as we know that sum of angles of pentagon is equal to 540 degrees. So we'll use here 540. First of all, here we have given this interior angle. These are 2x. We have not given these two angles. So firstly, we will find out these two interior angles. Right? Firstly, we will find out these two interior angles. So this is 1 and this is 2. So firstly, we will find out angle 1 and 2. Angle 1 plus 70 degree is equal to 180 degree. Angle 1 plus 70 is equal to 180 degree. Then, because it's forming linear pair, or you can say they both lie on the straight line, so we can say angle 1 plus 70 is equal to 180 degree. So angle 1 from here will be 180 minus 70 is equal to 110 degree. Similarly, we can find out angle 2 also. 180 minus 60, angle 2 will be 180 minus 60 is equal to 120 degree, right? Then now we got it's 110 degree, it's 120 degree. Now easily we can find out x as x plus x by angle sum property of pentagon. X plus 30 degree plus 110 degree plus 120 degree is equal to 540 degree, because sum of angles of a pentagon is 540. There are 5 angles now. 2x plus, it will be 140 plus 20, 160, 260 is equal to 540 degree. 2x is equal to 540 degree minus 260 degree. 2x is equal to, it will be 280 degree. Divided by 2 now, it will be 140 degrees. The value of x will be 140 degree. And here we'll use 540 degree sum of angles as sum of angles, because here we have given pentagon, 5 sides. When the 5 sides are given, Then how can we find out sum of angles? 5 minus 2 multiply 180. That is 3 multiply 180 is equal to 540 degree. Let's do D part now. So how many sides we have given here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 sides are given here. Here again we have given pentagon. And here it's given regular pentagon. That means all sides and angles are equal. So how can we do it? It's so easy. All the angles are x here. X plus x plus x plus x plus x is equal to. And it's a pentagon. So sum of angle will be 540 degree. So it is 5 times x. 1x plus 1x plus 1x plus 1x plus 1x. 5x is equal to 540 degree. Divided by 5, you will get 108 degree. All angles are here 108 degree. So complete up to 6 questions. 7th question we'll do in next class.